back to the second section of our chapter, that is classification of plants. Now, in the last section, we had studied about cryptograms. Now, we'll see the phenograms. Now, plants which have special structures for reproduction and produce seed. So, the plants which produce seeds and they have certain structures for reproduction are called phenograms. Now, in these plants, after the process of reproduction, seeds are formed which contain the embryo and the stored food for the embryo. Now, during germination of seed, the stored food is used for the initial growth of the embryo. So, remember, these seeds which are formed will contain the embryo and the stored food. And the stored food, during germination, the stored food will help the embryo to nourish. Now, depending upon whether the seeds are enclosed in the fruits or not, phenograms are further classified into gymnosperms and angiosperms. Now, gymnosperms. Now, gymnos means naked and sperms means seeds, means naked seeds. Now, gymnosperms are mostly evergreen, always they are green. Perennial means throughout the year, and woody, always they are green. Their stems are without branches. Their stems, they don't have a branch. Now, as you can see on page number 78, the leaves form a crown, like in case of a cytis plant. See, the cytis photograph is given over there. So, they don't have a branch, but they have the upper part of the tree as a crown. Now, these plants bear male and female flowers on different sporophylls of the same plant. Now, sporophyll means the leaf which have the spores. Now, seeds of these plants, they do not have natural covering. The seeds are naked. The plants, they do not form fruits and are therefore called gymnosperms, naked seeds. Now, for example, we have cycas, Bichia, Thuja. Thuja is the more punky, we say. Pinus is the deodar, etc. Now, the second division is angiosperms. Now, angiosperms, they are concealed. Angios means concealed or hidden. And sperms means seeds. Now, the flowers these plants bear are reproductive organs. These plants are the angiosperms are the flowering plants. So, you will find they take place over majority of the earth's surface. Means most of the flowering plants present on the earth, they are angiosperms. Now, the flowers these plants bear are the reproductive organs, because out of flowers only the fruits will be formed. Flowers develop into fruit and seeds are formed within the fruits. Now, seeds, they are enclosed by the fruit. That is why we say hidden seeds. Thus, the seeds are covered, hence they are called angiosperms. The plants whose seeds can be further divided into two equal halves or dicotyledons are called dicotyledons plant. And those whose seeds cannot be further divided into two equal parts, that is known as monocotyledonous plants. So, the plants whose seeds can be further divided into two halves, they are known as dicotyledonous. And those whose seeds cannot be further divided into two halves, that is known as monocotyledonous seeds. Now, plants. Now, for example of angiosperms, you will find we discussed lily, wheat, rice, and corn. Now we'll see on page number 79, they have given a differentiation between a dicotyledonous plant and a monocotyledonous. The seeds, they have two cotyledons. And for monocotyledons, they have only single cotyledon. It cannot be broken into, broken into two parts. It will not have two parts, only a single part. Root, well-developed primary root. And for monocotyledonous, it is fibrous root. Now, primary root, that is taproot. You must have known, the taproot is the single root which goes like this. And from the sides, then you have the secondary roots coming in. Now, this is the taproot. Now, this is seen in the dicotyledonous plant. Now, The second one, you see the fibrous roots. The fibrous roots are the roots which we can see normally which grow like this. They don't have a definite middle part, a strong middle part. So these are the fibrous roots. Strong, hard stem like that of banyan tree. Now banyan tree has a strong, hard stem. In monocotyledonous, it is hollow. Stem is hollow. For example, bamboo, disc-like in onion. Now, for leaf, the venation. Venation means what? For a dicotyledonous plant, it is reticulate venation. And for a monocotyledonous plant, it is parallel venation. Now, this means you must have observed. Now, if you have a plant at home, you can observe this. See, if some of the leaves, now they have like these veins. When the veins are straight, it is parallel venation. And this you must have seen often, like this. This is reticulate venation. So this is reticulate venation, and this is parallel venation. This is reticulate venation. Now flowers. Flowers with 4 or 5 parts of there in their multiples. They are tetramerous or pentamerous. Means they have 4 groups of each part of flower. Here it is 3 parts in monocotyledonous. Now see, further they have given a sketch diagram for kingdom plantae in short. So kingdom plantae is divided into cryptograms and phanerograms. Cryptograms, they are further divided into thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta. What we did now is phanerograms. Now phanerograms, they are divided into gymnosperms and angiosperms. Where angiosperms are further divided into dicotyledonous and monocotyledonous. So I hope you have understood this classification of plants. Do read the chapter and understand the things. Thank you.